Denver 8 TV, your city, your source.
We're the Dead End Drivers. We're on the Denver Loft Sessions, right here, right now.
My name's Ian Tyson. I was born here in Denver, and I play lead guitar for the Dead End Drivers.
My name's Lou Kupka. I'm from Denver, Colorado, and I play the rhythm guitar and lead vocals.
Hi, my name is Matt Wilson. I'm from Denver, Colorado, and I play the drum kit.
Hi, I'm Sam Martins. I'm from Denver, Colorado, and I play bass. Family reunions. It's wild. There are, my dad has four brothers, and three of them play guitar, and they all play at the same time. And then everyone sings and everyone plays, and it's a hullabaloo.
The summer between middle school and high school, I bought an Epiphone SG. It was the first electric guitar, you know, it was the junior. It only had one knob and everything. And that got me through for quite a while, and then some very good friends of mine bought me my Gibson Les Paul Classic, which is a beautiful guitar, and it plays beautifully, and I just love that thing more than most other things.
First experience with music was when I joined the Colorado Honor Band in fourth grade, and I didn't know what I was doing at all. I just wanted to play something, but I started. Actually, clarinet was my first instrument I played, but I was always wanting to play on the drums when I heard the drummers playing, and I'm like, well, you know, why can't I do that? So after a couple more years, I decided to do that in middle school, and kind of clicked.
I was 7 years old. I remember hearing a bunch of music on the radio that I liked. Got myself signed up for some music lessons, piano, and realized I learned it really, really quickly. Like, I was in and out of there in like a month. So I just wanted to do that from there on. It was like, you know, realizing how happy it made me and, you know, what I could do with it. So just from there on, it's just been like an addiction, so.
Close the curtain and take the stage. I'm sitting there, so have you say, right here next to me, right here next to me. Thinking for a bit of a week now. I know I'm trying and I think that I can learn how to make you smile, make you proud, make you sing this. Make you sing this out loud. I'm holding her for the first time. In a long time, seems like everything's fine. And this city's burning down. I'll keep you safe and sound. What am I to do? Stay here in love with you. You left me standing here, all alone in the street. Why can't you see? Without you I can't sleep. And on top of my head, the rain comes pouring down. Point her for the first time in a long time, seems like getting fine. And this city's burning down. I'll keep you safe and sound. What am I to do? Say him in love with you. Seems like everything's fine. And this city's burning down. I'll keep you safe and sound. What am I to do? Stay here in love with you. This city's making its way down. Hidden treasure in this town. Keep you safe here. I'll keep you safe here. Cross my heart and hope to see all the things that I want to be. I
think I finally found the key, and this will work eventually.
I fight with all of them, and I get along with all of them. So it just depends on the day. Sometimes I wake up on the wrong end of the bed, you know. But I mean, they're all my best friends. So it's like they're your family, you know. You fight with them, but then you get along with them, and then when you're getting along, you create great music.
If you enjoy the arts, which are a big part of civic life, then stay informed on other civic things by watching award-winning local TV programs and city council meetings live and on demand every day on Denver 8 TV.
Denver is home to some of the country's best places for concerts, theaters, and events. We're also home to a vibrant arts and cultural scene. That's Arts and Venues Denver. Red Rocks Amphitheater, that's Arts and Venues Denver. The Performing Arts Complex, that's Arts and Venues Denver. The Convention Center, Coliseum, and McNichols Civic Center, that's Arts and Venues Denver. Look around at Denver's array of public art. That's Arts and Venues Denver too, guiding and maintaining the city's distinguished display. And it's also diverse cultural programs, such as One Book, One Denver, Film Fiesta, and the Five Points Jazz Festival. Arts and Venues Denver aims to amplify our quality of life and enrich our city's vibrancy and culture. Arts and Venues Denver, a dynamic city agency serving you.
House of lights.
I find that it's really interesting to get to know the other bands in Denver. They're always really good to us. They're always willing to help us out with gigs that we need to play, and then we'll help them out in return if we can.
I think the Denver music scene is very unique because there are actually some very big venues that almost seem underappreciated. Maybe that's not the best word for it, but there are a lot of great venues here that some great acts have come to, and I think that's great for us being a local band here, because as we build the ladder for more venues that we try to look up to, we have something to strive for. Like, we don't have giant places that are being played, but we have some good venues to strive for, and it's nothing so crazy that it seems like a pipe dream, but something that we could actually potentially achieve. So I think that's a great thing about the Denver music scene.
Lots of underground stuff, but complementing that, there's a large underground fan base, and that really helps keep the scene very vibrant.
I really love the Denver music scene. Every band I've ever met has been super nice, super kind to us, and we've just been able to make a bunch of friends.
Sting.
You know, I think David Spade would do a really great job. Like, he would nail it.
Probably Christopher Walken, but I would maybe take a second for Willem Dafoe or William Shatner, someone like that.
I mean, I'd hope Leonardo DiCaprio would play me, just so, you know, my life's not that interesting, but, you know, he's kind of cool, he's good looking. I think we kind of look similar, so.
Ian called me up, said, you want to be in the band? I was like, okay. The band's name is Dead End Drivers? Okay. That's my version.
Access to performing arts can strengthen our community. Levitt Pavilion Denver will break ground on a state-of-the-art amphitheater in Ruby Hill Park in 2015. It's a unique partnership between the City and County of Denver and the national nonprofit Levitt Pavilions, and it's going to be Denver's next great outdoor concert venue. When it opens in 2016, Levitt Pavilion Denver will provide 50 free concerts a year featuring some of our best local musicians, as well as national and international artists. So get informed, get involved, and even make a contribution.
Experience the magic of Red Rocks and the spectacular amphitheater that plays host to a wide variety of musical acts, including those performing as part of the Film on the Rocks movie series. From top local performers to national breakouts, most are playing Red Rocks for the very first time. Join us for a rich sampling of their premiere performances on Red Rocks Premieres on Denver 8 TV.
down the same old road without a destination.
Inspired to create original music and have fun, Denver's Tenurtle brings their electro-funk hip-hop to the next Denver Loft Sessions.
Denver 8 TV, your city, your source.